Welcome back to the Caves of Ilum, where we shall all roll destiny. Is what I think we're gonna do.
Yes, please reset all seven darks.
Yes, I did. Okay, alright. You guys are just giving it back to me.
And I roll for you.
Yeah, indeed.
You're welcome.
You guys are just giving it back to me. Wow, I appreciate it.
It'll come back to us.
Wait, we're missing one, right?
No, that is correct. We're technically missing a player if you want to roll for him.
Oh, no, we can roll more. Never mind.
Yeah.
There were seven last time, and then we had six this time, but I see men.
Yes. There were two darks at first, and then another
that's
dark,
right.
And then a light,
we
and
had
then two more.
Yeah, we rolled very poorly, even worse last time.
You rolled good for me. But
hey, I'm just saying, I start going postal and that turns into good for me too.
But taking us into the scene, the two Jedi, Owen and Aldous, and the commando droid known as Mando, stand at the front of a cave, illuminated by your own lightsabers and the bright purple light of Mace Windu. And if I remember correctly, both of you did introduce yourselves from last we left off.
I don't think by name, but yeah, we addressed him as Master Windu.
He addressed him, and I'm kind of like sticking behind him.
Mm-hmm. So here's how I'm going to set these tokens, like kind of like this.
Yeah,
makes sense. Okay.
You approach. The old Master Windu doesn't say anything yet. What do? You can see behind him, through the shine of the lightsaber, seem to be a group of younglings.
After the disturbance I felt in the Force, it is good to see that others survived.
I would think you're saying
as
this
as slowly
we're
approach
forward.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Not too hastily, but just moving forward.
There we go.
In fact, is it light enough in here? Because I don't remember activating my lightsaber, but if I did, I'll deactivate it.
I think it's just the sun's just going down, right? Because we had to find shelter.
Yeah, there's light enough from the lightsabers. I just turned off all of dark vision so everyone could accurately see the map without being limited by only barely any dark vision because of lightsabers. I don't know how bright lightsabers are, but from what I remember watching the cartoons, it's like they barely light up like 10 feet in front of you.
It's like a glow stick, I guess.
Which, if you're asking me for the like single best weapon in the Star Wars universe, that's so stupid.
It should be a little brighter.
Well, there's some crystal and ice in here that's casting reflections, so it's probably lighter than,
Yeah, well, yeah, it's
probably
not just
like
cave, there is
ice.
Probably
look like we're in a John Wick final boss room.
Yeah. Yeah, this is where you fight Donnie Yen.
I think Donnie Yen's already dead in this universe.
Oh, yeah. Well, no, we're not there yet. Unless you stop it. Unless you somehow stop it.
New goal.
Yeah, because we're not exactly at that yet. As a reminder for all viewers, this current timeline, we are a year out from Star Wars Rebels. We have just passed Obi-Wan Kenobi. We're about a year out from Rebels. So I think that puts us at like 6 BBY?
Kenobi, after that's Kenobi, right. Be... Yeah.
Yeah, somewhere around there. So the events of Rogue One, this is an alternate history, essentially, Star Wars. The events of Rogue One, or at least the group of Rogue One, could theoretically be saved from the planet that is not reaching my head.
Scarif.
Scarif, that's the one.
Scarif, yes.
But for now, you stand as a point to an alternate history Star Wars in front of an aged Mace Windu. Mace Windu, well, he was thrown out of a window.
Mace went out the window.
Yeah, he went out the window. But you stand in front of an aged Mace Windu, one eye, you can see part of his robes dangle over his arm, one of his arms. And he has a lightsaber, his purple lightsaber in hand as you approach. And Owen, you say, you know, after the, what was it, dark side of the Force, it's good to see others
the
still alive.
The disturbance that I felt that still survived. And then, I guess if nothing happens, we'll keep moving.
I'm going to, I believe I do not have my lightsaber ignited.
I don't think either of us ignited.
I think it was you, Aldis. I think because one of you ignited. Whoever had the orange or like the orange saber ignited theirs.
Neither of us have orange. Yeah. We have yellow.
Yeah, that's what I meant. One of you ignited a yellow saber.
Okay, well it was probably me. But considering he hasn't said anything, I'm going to hang back. Like I'm going to stop walking and just stand there. Because Aldis is going through some trust
issues. I would tell Mando to walk up a little closer, but not move any further past that, just to get him out of the cave entrance.
Mm-hmm. And I will proceed.
As you're
like over here.
Yeah, he's just standing there menacingly. As you approach, though, Mace does speak up, and I'm not even going to try to do an impression, because I can't. he says, what brings you to Ilum?
We came looking for you, actually. We had heard from a young Jedi Padawan that unfortunately is no longer with us, an Inquisitor killed him, that you were here.
Don't forget the crystal.
And, yeah, the crystal. I would mention the crystal.
Show me this crystal. You wear the armor of the ones that hunt us.
Do I have it or does Aldis have it? I can't remember if I gave it back. I think I did.
Let me see.
I would just nod back to Aldis if you have it.
I do indeed have it back. Or at least it's in my inventory.
I'll give you a nod.
My sabers. And I will walk.
I stole this armor from the Inquisitor that killed that Padawan. We killed it.
Would stop spazzing, please? Okay, there we go. And I remove the crystal from my pack, and I just hold it in front of me.
He will begin approaching. And he will actually deactivate his lightsaber as he approaches and says, it is good to see others alive. It is good to see the crystal not corrupted.
I take it you know what this is.
It is an ancient artifact of the Jedi. It can be used to enhance abilities, but more importantly, it will be able to be added to the crystals of the younglings behind me and aid in their training. Do you know the fate of the Jedi that left them with me? You said a Padawan died for this. What of the Jedi?
The Jedi captured. Master we have not made contact with, but yes, he's been captured.
He kind of just takes a moment.
We had made it off. We had made it off Mimban ourselves just barely as the Inquisitors started coming in.
It was him or the crystal.
Oh,
necessary sacrifice then for the turning point of the Jedi Order.
What would you have us do?
How have you arrived here? I assume you got through the blockades.
Yes, we stole an Inquisitor ship, the one that I mentioned we killed, which is where I got this armor. And that's how we got off Mimban.
I'm not in my peak form anymore. I would like if you could cut up the crystal in your care and place it in the training sabers of the younglings. It will power their sabers even further, and we will be able to begin training. After, we need to find a way off planet. If you have arrived here once, have you alerted the garrisons?
There was a patrol that tried to follow us.
I was going to say, they do know we're on planet, right?
What was that?
I was just asking Pi. They do know we're on planet, yeah.
They definitely know something's on planet.
They know somebody's on planet. They don't know who.
They don't know because they never had a chance to get comms off saying, oh shit, there's Jedi, considering they got mauled to death by giant creatures.
Okay. Okay.
But that's how they would have wanted to go.
But they definitely...
So they know there's a disturbance of some kind on planet.
They know that there's a disturbance of some kind on planet, and I'm actually going to ask Morwenna, who is already hooked in to the systems, and I'm going to give you an extra blue die because of Gonk. I would like you to make a... This will just be a one difficulty... I would like you to make me a computers.
Hey.
You can hear with the help of Gonk if someone wants to give me a Gonk real quick.
Gonk.
Gonk, Gonk.
Gonk, Gonk.
Or you can use this. Yeah, there it is.
I'm a boomer. I don't know how those work.
You can hear... scrambling. It's not coming from the one of the ships above Ilum, but it seems to be rather like local comms, perhaps from one of the garrisons on planet. But you can hear on the other end, like, you know, Trooper 965 or whatever, respond, why aren't you responding? And then dead air. And then you can hear what you can presume to be an officer on the other end saying, possibly contacting like a barracks and requesting a greater patrol of units to be sent out to their location.
Hearing that, I would try to calm to Aldous and Owen that it seems like they're starting to like be concerned about their patrol that's missing, and that they're about to like be bringing in extra force. We need to mobilize and get out of here fast.
Can I do my doodad to see if I sense any dark side presences?
You can do a doodad. I believe it was just a presence roll. And I'm gonna set the difficulty, which has been set.
Was presence or perception?
What's better for you?
Perception.
Do that.
I think we've been doing that. Oop. Scrolled up.
Oh dang.
Holy.
Alright. You're gonna take a strain as you feel out into the force. You take a moment. You're listening in into the force, you're feeling out into the force for any dark side. And as you do this, Mace kind of takes a moment to begin doing it as well. Concerned by your sudden, you know, piercing into the force. And you don't feel the presence of someone who wields the dark side of the Force. You do, however, feel the presence of something jumping into the system above Ilum. And a presence that seems to be, that feels possibly familiar even. The presence of a certain squadron of troops.
Oh.
Ah, shit, here we go again. I'll snap
what,
out
what
of
have
my...
you sensed, my friend?
And I will even add more. With that many successes, it didn't feel like a full-blown, like destroyer ship. It felt like a transport ship entering the system.
The squadron's own transport ship, probably, yeah.
Yeah.
The hell are these guys called? The
Scar?
Scar.
Scar Squadron.
I think Scar has found us.
Again? Well, that didn't take that long.
Who knows? They had... What was it? They had the Padawan's master. He may have cracked.
The Jedi master, his name was...
I was going to say, I know you gave us a name.
I know I had the Padawan's name. We're gonna okay, unless one of you have it in your notes, I'm renaming the master.
Let me check my notes real quick. I'm pretty certain I have.
Yeah, let me look. No, I don't have it.
Man, I gotta scroll far for this. Nope, he's getting renamed.
He's getting renamed. He's getting renamed to Kuh. He's getting renamed to Kuh Reg.
That sounds great.
And he's a Zabrak.
Oh.
I think he definitely was a Zabrak, so that checks. Master Kuh Reg may have cracked.
It is possible, but.
Master, we need to get
I do suggest we get we need to
they
move.
Can't hide here forever.
I agree. There's only one problem. If you've
we
made
can
it
get them off the planet.
If you've made it this far and they know of your presence and they know of our presence, they've likely set up the ground to air weaponry. How confident are you in your pilot?
Rowena, can you outrun some artillery?
I mean, maybe, but it'll be fun.
You can get us through the Imperial scum, I'm sure.
How did you get here, Master? Are there any other transports?
You see, he takes a moment, and if this is where the PTSD would break in, it'd be this moment, as he kind of, like, with his one good eye, he zones out, and he says...
I buried my ship when I landed here. It is in no condition.
Then we don't
Luckily,
have any options.
Luckily, we're on one of the Inquisitor transport ships, so we have room.
We don't have any
We're
going
to have to get them on board
we
now.
We have to flee now, or they're going to realize who is actually here, and they'll mobilize the entire fleet.
I agree. How fast can your pilot... How far away is your ship, or can you call your pilot here?
Marina, how long?
That's a good question. How far are we?
You've been, you've been walking for some time. Long enough for it to go from, you know, day to dark.
Maybe half a day's walk, but
yeah,
it would be quick if
we
could fly here.
And I mean,
yeah, I guess we can radio over tomorrow. How fast can you get here?
Let me find something out. I'm going to ask for a roll from a certain person.
Uh-huh.
Totally not going to be piloting planetary.
No. I would like Mando to give me a computers.
Ooh.
I know. Gasp.
Very well, very well.
A guest.
Oh.
You're a literal robot. How does that even happen?
Morwenna has advantage that she didn't use. Just saying.
Advantage only lasts for the current... Oh yeah, you could have given advantage.
Yeah, she could have passed it on.
Baroni.
Yeah.
Give me a reroll?
Yeah, sure. I'll give my advantage over.
Yeah, give me a reroll.
Ready?
Yep. Okay. I'm a kind GM.
I'm a generous GM.
Quite generous.
The force is with us. I don't want you all to fail so soon, as I am quite interested in your... Oh, I'm forgetting the quote.
Escape plan. We need to progress the plot.
Yeah, you need to progress the plot of the story, man.
Plot armor?
With two successes, despite not being asked to do it, Mando, you know that within your own droid systems, you would be able to relay coordinates of this cave, if needed.
I just might do so.
I would ask Dio to transmit those to Morwenna.
And Morwenna, if you take off towards the cave, how fast do you go? How fast do you jettison?
We'll try to get there as quickly as possible.
All right. Well, give me, because it is a spaceship.
It will be
it will be piloting space. I'm going to put a dark side point on this.
Due to my skill jockey, I get to remove up to two black die, or however that works.
You do, your skill actually removes the dark side point.
Yeah, I'll go ahead and make that rule.
God dang!
A triumph.
She straight up, you make a barely bursts out of the snow and is, staying so low radar, it's ridiculous. Just skimming inches above the surface.
It's like Tom Cruise in a top gun.
Yeah, Danger Zone plays in the background.
Hold on, I need to grab something. Wow, that's good.
Man, you just made John Hamm look like an asshole. I love that little cardboard cutout looking ship.
Yeah.
Drifts it in like an interstellar.
Murph. Right here. That's where it is. That's where it's going.
Get into a landing perfectly inside the cave entrance.
Yeah.
Master, our pilots arrived.
And I want. I would like. Wow, that's really good.
Right? Just Earth shakes. I think our pilot's here.
if this was a ubiquity system, you would have gotten 17 style points for that.
I like to imagine that Mando had been relaying coordinates the entire time, and Mace didn't even get the sentence out. I was like, how fast can she get here? And then boom. She whips it in.
Yes. You know, I mean, with the triumph, that could just be the case. Yeah. I would like
master the pilots here.
Yeah, I would like, this is gonna be a hard roll because of how fast you're going, but I would like a perception from Morwenna.
A perception, I get a free blue die due to my tendrils. Okay. Where is perception again? There it is. Yeah, she's just in the zone. She's not paying attention to anything else.
Yeah, you are just in the zone, and Mace isn't... Yeah, Mace barely has... How good is
going your...
And suddenly just... Whoom, lands directly in front of the cave.
Alright, let's get these Padawans on board. We need to get out of here.
And you're all able to board the Scythe, Padawans included, as they are in... They are in awe.
All right, welcome aboard the site. Now this is where they would strap down the Jedi they kidnapped.
And suddenly, Morwenna, you have a lot of new faces aboard your ship.
The goons are all in.
Master, do you know of a safe place we can go to? Or have you been here for, I don't know, how long you've been here?
As soon as everyone is in the ship, Morwenna just kicks it. She's already having Gonk help her coordinate to, well, you know where she wants to go.
Yeah, I know where she wants to go. I don't know if the others do, but you are able to kick it off. The ship immediately takes off, and I'm going to ask for another... Let me set the difficulty.
Refresh my memory. Does this ship have weapons?
It does. It has two cannons.
Two cannons. Okay, that's right.
I will ask...
I will preemptively sit down in one of those just to be safe.
All right. I'm gonna ask for another piloting space. Let me turn on some heavy music here. Some General Grievous.
Once again, skilled jockey 2, I get to remove up to 2 black die. Mm-hmm.
Can I use a light side point on behalf of someone else?
I believe you can, yes.
I'm with the Force.
We need to get off planet.
I'm with the Force trying to keep Morwenna calm and clear her mind.
Okay. Wow. Wow, is it even needed?
We don't have any trouble getting off planet at all.
That's insane.
Y'all thought this was a Jedi party. It's really just Morwenna and her bitches.
Danger zone intensifies.
You take off.
It never stopped playing.
And you don't even have the time. Like, the Imperials don't even have the time to set up their cannons. Like, you're already in space by the time they're aiming. And you're able to get into orbit, you know, the space above Ilum in, like snap. You would have seen, if anyone was looking out of the windows, like one of the Padawans may have been like, "Masters, look!" And they would have pointed out a large contingent of troopers down below in the snow. At least 20.
So I imagine, since she's gotten the message, she has been like having Gonk and herself like having the like astro like coordinates prepared and all that. The moment we break atmosphere, she's hitting warp.
And with double triumphs, Scar Squadron doesn't even have a chance to begin entering orbit of the planet before you're already gone.
Man. They basically jumped into the planet and we jumped out.
Look at Discord. This is what happened.
Okay.
Us and Scar Squadron just...
Yeah, for Scar Squadron. For the yeah. Viewers, it is the GIF from the Umbrella Academy of Vanya and Fives looking at each other in the cars. It's very accurate.
Star Squadron.
Except Vanya is slipping off 5.
Yeah. And just hilarious. Like that, you're hitting hyperdrive. You're hitting hyperspace. You are out of Ilum. And let me move you guys. Well, I think I'm just going to move you guys to this map. So... I'm just gonna throw this out there.
Session over. That's all.
No, yeah, session over. We played 28 minutes. No, we're gonna keep going. I may not have the maps, but I can certainly damn well describe things.
That's fine.
Hey, that's the way this campaign started. So.
But what I was gonna say is, because of Morwenna's double triumphs in piloting and so many successes, you. First of all, you avoided being shot down. Second of all, which is the big one, the second thing is the biggest one, you completely avoided an entire Imperial base dungeon crawl I had.
We got down there, got Mace off planet, and just avoided the Imperial
dungeon.
That's
a future one shot.
Yeah, because if Morwenna wasn't able to get to the caves immediately, Mace would have been like, "They're setting up the cannons. We have to stop them first to be able to get off planet."
So, essentially, future one-shot, we go back in time, and that's what happens.
the future one shot is you guys playing the snowtroopers and being chewed out by an officer. Yeah.
I'm sorry, sir. They were too bad.
You guys are in space, and Mace Windu is like surprised. You got them out of there so quickly.
Yeah, we have a really good pilot.
We've been through some stuff.
So, the moment that we're like in warp, right?
Morwenna's cloak and everything.
What's Morwenna doing?
She's going to go over the comm and be like, I need to talk to, like, people. Like, people, please. Come, like, not, like, you guys, not the younglings. Come to the cockpit. We need to talk.
I would walk up to the cockpit.
I'll get out of my little, cannon.
As I'm taking off my outer cloak, yep.
Oh, yeah. Gotta change my doodad.
Yeah, I gotta do that.
But you're, like, sweating profusely.
And it's just, like, whip off the mask. Like, once I remember where to
go. And there's that. It's under bio.
Bio info, that's right.
Edit.
Or you can hit edit. That is a very good note to make, Aldis. That is a very good note to make.
Second argument, third failure, Scar Squad. Oh, yeah. Scar Squadron cannot catch a break.
Yeah. First, they lose their heavy.
We kill
Scar Squadron's choking hard.
I kill their heavy member, and then they zoom in here, try to catch us, and we're gone.
And we humiliated their sniper, too, as I yoinked her weapon out of her hands.
And which you no longer have.
It's with top men.
It's being sent off to be looked at.
Okay, that didn't work. I'll be right back.
So do you guys go to the cockpit to talk with...
Yes.
Yeah, as we were shrugging off our snow gear, we were walking that way.
Yeah, I'll follow Owen.
Mace will actually come too. Mace will, you know... Basically, let the Padawans watch out the windows, see the wonders of space.
Wow, they never let us do these field trips on Coruscant.
Mm-hmm. And so Mace would also approach the cockpit.
Oh, that's so morbid.
When they get into the cockpit, Morwenna would, like, tap Gonk and have Gonk replay the message that she received.
And the message, I actually need to refine that. Let me see.
Is this where you're trying to take us? Is where the message is pertaining to?
Yeah.
So, as Gonk replays, "You're my only hope, Obi-Wan."
I knew it.
Gonk replays a message, an Imperial message. Actually.
Oh, thank God.
Relaying information that multiple contingents, multiple ships are being sent to the Mikkian homeworld, Mikkia, to quell rebellions and round up the Mikkians to shut it down.
He would, like... While the message is playing, she's, like, 100%, like, focused on, like, you know, the numbers and everything of, like, the route. But, like, she would, like, look back and be like, "That's my home. My family lives there."
Good. My next question was, why did we care? That's good info.
Good info to know.
It's like, oh, my God, a name I don't know.
Mikkia, what is that?
And actually,
I'm Mikkian.
And, okay. Yeah, and I will say whether the Jedi think they would know this or not, I actually won't even give you a role, because I think it would be general, Jedi knowledge. Mikkia was a very staunch member and supportive member. of the Galactic Republic during the Jedi Order. They were very big supporters of the Jedi Order, and when the Jedi Order fell, they became a very heavy, you know, anti-imperial planet.
This may be an opportunity that just come knocking for us. We need to...
How so?
Not only save your family, but this is maybe a safe place to go. We would have support there.
Indeed, 100%.
Do we want that kind of target on a place where we're trying to rebuild the order? Those aren't Jedi Knights out there. They're children. I don't think any of them even had masters yet.
Unfortunately, no. They were brought to Ilum. Most that I knew was Jedi Master Kareg found them after the fall. Brought them, and then they found me. But this could be a chance to strike back. It may not be the safest, but you said you have family there. Looking, and he says this as he looks at Morwenna. Do you have family that could house a grouping of younglings long enough just for them to learn the basics? Perhaps with some combat knowledge, we could aid the Mikkians long enough for them to learn and begin our fight back against the Empire.
Long enough for the Inquisitors to come at the call of 6 Force users. Or more. I forget how many there were. I didn't count.
I think Mace is talking about just us three while they train.
Morwenna will be like, if we can get there before them, and, you know, nothing's happened to my family yet, I'm sure that they would help. And then she'll look over at, Owen and Aldous and be like, you guys have already killed one Inquisitioner, correct? What's a couple more?
Because there aren't just Inquisitors.
If it's one-on-one, that's a different story. There's garrisons and Scar Squadron.
At this point, I will also inform Mace Windu about my vision of us fighting a large Dark Force user clad in black. Because I don't remember if I know him.
I
don't think I do.
I don't believe you would know Darth Vader, no.
I think we agreed that we knew some kind of, other Sith, but I don't have, a face to the name.
Yeah, I think we also agreed to the fact that...
You've heard the name, probably, Darth Vader, but yeah, not seen him.
I think it's also... It's very possible that you also know... You knew pre-corruption Anakin Skywalker. Who didn't know Anakin Skywalker?
Yeah, right.
But yeah,
like
I think
Golden it's like Captain Boy. America.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Exactly. But I think
in the myth, the legend.
Yeah, but I do think we did agree upon that you are not aware that Anakin Skywalker equals Darth Vader.
Definitely. Yeah.
None of us except maybe Mace.
That is accurate, Mace. That, yeah. And actually, I'm going to ask for a perception check. Is Morwenna focusing on flying, or is she looking at everyone?
For the most part, she's focusing on flying.
Okay, so then I'm going to first I'm going to first ask a perception check from Owen.
Blue die for uncanny senses.
Okay.
Is it to sense Altus's blood pressure rising?
Alright, now a perception from Aldous.
Jeez.
And then a perception from Mando. Alright, so you're going to take a strain, Aldous.
Okay.
You bring up your visions that you received back on Mimban, again, Mace kind of hits a moment of just staring off into nothingness. And you can see not so much as panic, but like a sense of unease coming from the old master. And he says in a tone of like a mixture of a tone of semi-confidence, but also, you know, whenever like a reboot movie comes out and the main character of the old movies is like this grizzled character who like doesn't care what happens to them, like Rambo.
Oh yeah.
He has a tone of that in his voice when he says, "If they come to planet, let me deal with them."
You know who it is.
I am aware of who it likely is. Yes.
Who is it?
It is not a tale most would tell you. No.
All right, GG's, guys. That's all for me. I'll see you. I'll talk to you tomorrow.
He was a promising Jedi. A bit arrogant. A bit brash. Yeah, I can't tell you till episode 5.
Oh, that's good.
That's funny. But Mace would know. Mace would know. And he would lean in to say it. He wouldn't want the younglings to hear it. You would get the name Darth Vader. You would get the name Anakin Skywalker.
More like he doesn't want the younglings to have PTSD.
Yeah. But you would get, he would say, Anakin Skywalker is now Darth Vader. The right hand of the Emperor.
Alright. Aldous takes it like a champ.
You know what? Yeah, roll a cool as well, Owen.
Where? There it is.
Whew. And I imagine
very cool Jedi.
Yeah, I imagine it's,
I'm not surprised because I've probably talked to my brother.
I imagine it's less likely that you guys are so chill about it, and more so that
I don't freak out about it.
Yeah, you don't freak like out about it.
Silence. I don't know what to say.
Yeah, it's like, oh, damn, Anakin Skywalker's on the bad team now?
It's just the realization of it.
Yeah, it's the realization.
Pac-Man's a bad guy?
That's a good movie, damn it. I will defend that movie. I like pixels. And Morwenna, I would ask you to do a cool, but it all depends. Like, I don't think you really know much about the deeper Jedi Order.
No, not really.
Morwenna is like the college humor skit where the guy like has his grandfather is the Nazi, but he doesn't know it. He's like,
yes.
Anakin Skywalker's Darth Vader. Oh my god! Names I do not know.
Anakin Skywalker. I'm pretty sure I used to drink with him.
I'm pretty sure I know what the answer is going to be, but I'm going to ask Mace if he's heard anything about Obi-Wan.
He would tell you the information that happens in, what was it, episode 3? That he went to Utapau. He had a mission on Utapau, and that was the last he heard of Obi-Wan. Been on Ilum too long to really receive any new news.
That's actually fair, because they really stopped communicating with each other after that. A lot of the masters just went completely dark.
Yeah, and that was
worth a shot.
That was the last like official mission of Obi-Wan Kenobi before the fall, going to Utapau. What are you doing?
What's the play now with this information and the information that you're heading to Mikkia?
Is there anywhere on planet that would be way out of the way that they wouldn't think to go look at?
Morwenna, if you don't immediately land, you know, in like a city that you know your family lives in, you're familiar with the planet. You know that there are likely points of the planet that the Empire wouldn't directly go to. The Empire would likely be hitting all the towns and the cities. And it is a very jungly, it is a mixture of jungle and ice planet.
Would there maybe be a, like a place where like Morwenna would like run away to or something like growing up?
If you want to, ooh, this is interesting. I'm going to twist this a little bit. I'm going to use a dark side point. On Mikkia, because it was a very Galactic Republic planet, and the
Jedi
wiki
Order
support. Yeah, the wiki doesn't say there weren't wars there. So I'm going to say, with this flip of a dark side point,
an old Jedi temple.
No. In fact, a Lucre Hulk.
Oh.
A droid, an old droid Lucre Hulk,
oh,
used to be a spot that you would run away to learn about ships. That was a spot you would go to, you would study the ships. However, you never fully explored the Lucre Hulk, as one day you heard some noises and you didn't know what it was. Was it reactivated droids? Who knows? But you booked it out of there. So you stuck to what you know inside the Lucre Hulk. Welcome back, Aldous. I just spent a dark side point to say that Morwenna, when back on their homeworld of Mikkia, used to visit an old Lucre Hulk droid ship that crashed there during the wars, during the Clone Wars.
You need a dark side point for that?
I spent it because there are threats within the Lucre Hulk that may still be active. Normally, adding things into the world would be spending a light side point. Like, you could spend a light side point and say, actually, on Coruscant, one of my hideouts is right down the road. You know what I mean? But I'm spending a dark side point because I'm adding threat.
Yeah, I forgot we were doing that wrong in the beginning.
Yeah.
Okay. Morwenna would tell everyone of the Lucre Hulk she used to play in as a kid. But she would very much say that, like, though it's out of the way and, you know, probably unharassed, it's a derelict Lucre Hulk. There may still be dangers inside of it that she's not aware of.
Mando, what are the chances you have, you could guide us through those?
Oh, we're about to reunite you with your family.
Not his family anymore.
I mean, that Mando, when you were not a reprogrammed commando droid, and, you know, Mando may not know his past currently, but for the sake of it, was Mando ever, you know, deployed to Lucre Hulk ship? Was he ever, you know, dropped out of drop pods from Lucre Hulks during the war?
I'm sure he's been on similar, or maybe not the ship, but I'm sure he's been on one before.
I mean, all Lucre Hulks are based.
So there's the answer. You know, Mando, you know, with your... Actually, Mando, roll me a computers. And I'm going to give you a blue die because you're a droid.
Ready when you are.
It is set. When asked this question, would you be able to lead us through the Lucre Hulk? Would you be able to bring us through it? Perhaps...
I believe I could.
Yeah, perhaps Owen didn't wipe enough when he reprogrammed you. You know, some of your old programming is still there, so you would know the layout of an intact Lucre Hulk.
Right.
I mean, yeah, I didn't wipe everything anyway.
So you would be able to... know the layout of an intact, not derelict, Lucre Hulk.
I believe I can get it, sir.
Well, that seems as
if Mando's
good a place as any.
That's probably where we should land. We need to find your family soon after, though.
As soon as that's said, Morwenna will look over and be like, thank you, as she's like, goes back to like, finding where that Lucre Hulk was on like, the planet map, you know?
And that is a good point to bring up. And I would like a computers or a, let's see... And Gonk, the entire time Gonk is giving... Gonk will give anyone a extra blue die if anyone does activities on the ship. You just need to tell me where Gonk goes. Like, Gonk can't help you on the turrets if he's currently helping someone at the computers. You can give me a navigations or a computers, Morwenna.
Wait, navigation or...
computer.
You mean... Okay. We'll go with computers, why not? Nothing.
You aren't able to get a bead on the Lucre Hulk, right away. I will say, eventually, you know, between now and arriving to Mikkia, you are able to get a beat. You know it is located maybe, like, a day or two's, like, you know, you would spend time there. Like, you would hike there, you would go there. It is maybe a day or two away from the city that you grew up in. Like, this is a thing that your parents would be, you know... Where's Morwenna? We're worrying about Morwenna to the point where eventually they were like, she's a free spirit, and they just ended up buying you a communicators.
Like, right.
She's going to go anyways, so let's just make sure she's safe.
So, it's that far walking. That means it's far enough away.
And what were you gonna say before Morwenna?
Oh, I was just gonna ad lib that, like, you know, I can see them being like, stay away from the Lucre Hulk, and she's like, yeah, no.
Yeah. But yeah, you would know that it's about a day or two away from the city that you grew up in.
Okay.
So, and Mace would say so. The plans are to rest and take cover in this Lucre Hulk until we find
help the McKeans.
This one's family.
I think this would be the safest place.
And of course, train the younglings.
Safe as it can be on a planet like this.
In this galaxy, I don't know if that anywhere is really safe.
Until the Jedi Order is reestablished, that is.
As much as I would have disagreed to that when I left, now my mind is... I've had time to think. And I'm saying this in my mind.
Any plans for the lot of you before you jump into Mikkian space?
Would the travel time be long enough to rest?
Because I would say
getting rid of some strain.
Yeah, the level time. The travel time would be long enough to gain a rest.
Okay. How does recovering strain work?
Yeah.
Let me find that for you, my good man.
Oh, yeah, that's another thing. Since I believe a lot of us aren't really, like, wounded or anything, she would look over at Mace and be like, hey, if, you know, you or the younglings are, you know, under the weather or have any injuries, there's a Bacta tank in the back.
He would thank you for that. He would also say none of us seem to be injured. Yes, you would be able to get a long night's rest, so you would get, or a full night's rest, so you would remove all of your strain.
Cool.
And one night's rest heals one wound. So you'd also heal one wound if any of you received any.
Forget on our sheet, do we track it by going up or down?
When you are healing, you go down. When you're taking wounds, you go up. Because if you cross your threshold, you're unconscious.
Yeah, and your strain should be zero. If you have, like, no strain.
Zero threshold of blah, blah, blah.
Your current strain should be zero, and your threshold
is constant. Yeah, current zero, yeah.
Yep, yep, yep.
Yeah. And then wound is what? It just heal, or?
You heal one wound.
One, okay.
Do you have a wound?
I think my sheet's the most accurate. I have two current. I don't know if I'm supposed to say numbers or not, but whatever.
How dare you say numbers?
Can I try to use the kyber crystal to heal him?
You may.
Oh man, I didn't bring on my force powers.
Is it significantly smaller, or is it still intact at the moment?
We have not done anything with it yet.
You have not done anything with it yet. And when Mace sees you pull it out again to heal him, I'll just give it to you. I'll just allow you to heal him. But roll me... roll me your highest skill, Aldous.
Ooh. Okay. Find that. Let's see.
No modifiers to it, just straight roll.
Sheesh.
You can heal an additional... I'm going to double that. If anyone has wounds, you can heal your entire party in equal to 6 wounds. But it has to be like distributed. Like you can give 2 heals to Owen, 2 heals to yourself, etc.
Well, I have 0 wounds, so it is to whoever else needs it.
Then there'd be 3 of us left if you're just doing party members.
Yeah.
So each of us get 2 if you need it.
And Mace, seeing the crystal again, would say, when we land on planet and we are safe, I would like to take that and cut it up for the younglings.
If we are to begin their training, they do need to be stronger, not just training sabers.
I'm going to do a thing that you can do with what you will.
Okay.
I'm going to pull out the red crystal, and I'm going to ask Master Windu if he knows how this happened. Because I'm assuming that's not a thing that is, you know, taught in Jedi Sunday school.
The corrupted like crystal blend. From the...
Yes.
Inquisitor?
Yes.
Alright.
I'm assuming that's a bit of niche
That's probably a Jedi restricted section.
The restricted section, but Mace would know it. I'm not going to roll for Mace because I said I don't have a sheet, but it's Mace Windu. Do I really need to roll for something that he would likely already know?
Nah. He just says motherfucker and it happens.
Exactly, dude. If you look closely, his lightsaber hilt actually has BMF on it.
Mm-hmm.
All of his stats on his sheet, all of his skills are literally just motherfucker and they're all maxed.
Exactly. But Mace, which I don't know that... I don't remember the story off the top of my head or how it works, but Mace would tell you how it works.
And how to
cure
it, I'm sure. Purify it.
Yeah.
Would he tell me that purification is a thing, or is that a mystery that will continue to elude all of us?
No, he would tell you. He would tell you that purification of a corrupted kyber crystal is possible.
Can you teach me?
Motherfucker, I'm already teaching these younglings! No. He would essentially say, you know, what is, like, in due time. But first, the younglings.
I will return the crystal to its spot.
That's understandable. And I will bow my head. I assume that's like you have it in a bag on your belt. Its own pouch.
Yeah, it's actually on a chain around my neck.
There you go.
The Dark Lord Palpatine knows where I am.
Yeah, exactly.
With your rest and with your conversations, eventually you jump out, and before you is the planet of Mikkia. Morwenna's homeworld.
Hmm.
It's tropical, right?
It is a mix of...
And ice.
Yeah, it is a mix of tropical jungles, but very cold, icy poles.
So... It's
large poles, I take it.
Yeah, exactly. It's, glass, like a mix, it's a mixture of Felucia and Hoth.
That sounds terrible. I'll lean into Morwenna and I'll just ask, so which side do we get to go to?
Oh, definitely the tropical side. We don't really live on the icy thing.
They're just there.
Does anybody live there? Or is it just desolate?
I actually don't know.
You know what? It's gonna
tribe in the moon of Pandora.
Yeah, you ready for this? You ready for this? Morwenna, you don't know, but something lives there.
Oh. He's giving them to us. Just let it happen.
Yeah, the dark side point says something lives there.
All right, well, let's not go there. It is a silly place.
It's a Mikkian dragon. No.
Oh, a nice dragon.
On your face. Hey.
Hey.
But something lives there. Morwenna, you do not know what, but something. It is like an old children's tale. They would tell you to go to bed. You know, if you don't go to bed on time and eat your vegetables, the ice monster is going to get you.
Yeah, she will tell him about the... about the, like, Mikkian Krampus, and then, be like, it's just rumors, I don't really know. We didn't really travel over there. It's kind of cold. We don't really have fur.
Mando, what are the chances you could pull up some schematics or something, or give some insight to Owen Mace and myself as to, like, the kind of things that might be waiting for us inside this Lucre Hulk?
I can. Let's see.
That will be a...
Computers.
Yeah, a computers, and I'm gonna give you a blue die because of being a commando droid.
Good.
Alrighty, here we go.
Gonk help?
Well, unnecessary. It's not needed.
It's not needed.
Okay.
Transfer an automatic success token.
You pull up schematics like R2-D2, you know, you pull up maybe old schematics you didn't know that you had on your system anymore.
I'll but just turn shows... to Lewis and I'll say, you did a bang-up job getting rid of that clanker stuff in his head.
I wasn't trying to erase everything. I needed his programming, but I programmed it to take orders from me and help me out bounty hunting.
And before you would see the schematics of a droid, Luke or Hulk. Not only that, but, you know, details of the droids that would be within. You know, you have your B1s, you have your B2s.
B1's not a threat. B2's a little more so.
You have your...
B2's are the big motherfuckers.
You have your roly-polies.
More of a threat, yeah.
Some Luker Hulks, droidicas, that's what they're called. Some Luker Hulks are known to hold the dwarf spider droids and the, I believe they were... No, they're not called Viper droids. What were the ships?
Vulture. The Vulture class.
Yeah, they would
be the fighters.
Yeah, thank you, my good man.
Nightmare fuel buzz droids.
Yeah, they would also hold the Vulture droids. Most combat droids you can think of during the Clone Wars, the Luker class ships have.
Grievous's bodyguards were droids that they would have.
Yeah,
not to mention the C-9979 landing ship that they see in Episode 1.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, Luker Hulks hold a lot of droids, you know, the commander droids. Not the commando droids, but, you know, the ones who actually command the troops.
Yeah, the B1s with the silicone.
The droids that are just given their commander rank.
The B1s with a personality.
Yeah.
Are you talking about the strategy droids?
The strategy droids, yeah. And I don't think... Did Magna Guards ever leave Grievous's side? They were his bodyguards. Were Magna Guards ever used elsewhere?
No, I believe that they were personally made for him.
Pretty certain.
Yeah.
Ventress had a couple, I think.
Yeah, that's, I think, true. They were strictly bodyguards of, like, VIPs.
But they were part of the CIS. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you may not run into any... of them.
I don't know. Maybe if you play a certain Jedi sequel, you'll find out.
Oh!
The only thing I know about them is, like, personally off the top of my head, is that Grievous actually hated them, and had his personally modified.
Yeah, well, you know, Grievous was kind of a dingus because they rocked Jedi, okay? Let's be real. The Magna Guards hit hard.
Unless you're tier Jedi, then yeah.
If not harder than Grievous.
Yeah, if not harder than Grievous. I mean, they subdued the likes of Anakin Skywalker and Obi-Wan Kenobi, and Grievous got flopped by both.
Plot armor.
Yeah. Post-2003, Grievous was a punk.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, those... But continuing with the story, all of those droids tend to be a part of... the contingents on a Luker Hulk. However, this is a derelict and crashed Luker Hulk.
I would ask Morwenna, how intact is it, if you can remember?
Would that be a roll, or does she...
I am going to give it to you unless you think it should be a roll.
I mean, she spent a lot of time in it, so she would say that to her knowledge, it was pretty intact, but, like, it's been years since she's been back home, and, you know, wear, tear, you name it, like, you know.
Unless it's being upkept from the inside.
Yeah, it's intact enough for Morwenna to have been able to explore it. However, it's also on its side.
Oh,
so it kind of looks like that one ship from Prometheus.
Yes, it does.
So it's only slightly inconvenient. You were able to explore it, so you can walk around in it.
You can possibly climb in it.
So we've arrived outside of planet. Have we begun descent yet?
Morwenna, do you begin descending towards where you know the Lucre Hulk is?
I figure if we like come out of warp and we're there, she's gonna try to like immediately get there as fast as possible before, you know, like anyone could potentially notice. Speaking of which, when we come into the solar system space, right? Or the local space, I should say. Do we already see like Imperial like brigades, or have they not arrived yet?
Morwenna, give me a computers first.
Blue dice from gunk?
Yep.
Okay.
And then you're gonna take a strain, and then give me a perception.
Alright, just a sec. You know, there's one thing I absolutely hate is when you accidentally tap in your scroll wheel. Oof. And then, like, you're stuck in that, like, scroll. Anyways, where was my perception? Okay. But blue dice from,
yes, sir.
Tendrils. Brr. Hey, they actually did something.
With the computers, as you are getting closer to actually landing, like, you're in planet now. Your computers, you're able to pick up chatter from the Imperials. And you're able to tell there are at least 3 Star Destroyers being sent.
But they're not here yet.
One of them is about to leave warp and enter space. With your perception, you do not see it yet. It has not actually entered space yet, and it seems that the planet of Mikkia. And as you spy out the windows, you see your old city. And I imagine I'm just riffing because there's not a lot of lore about Mikkia. I'm picturing Mikkia kind of like Alderaan, you know, with those high rises.
Except jungle.
Mm-hmm. Except jungle. So maybe think a mixture of Alderaan buildings with Kashyyyk buildings.
Just say Japan, yeah. Man.
Yeah. So similar to that, and you can see your city.
Could I also make a perception, having heard the stuff from the computers, and I am not piloting?
You may,
yeah, because
I'm still right there, like kind of chatting.
You may. What would you like to make your perception for?
Just like generally things in orbit.
Okay.
Maybe like the flashes, you know, trying to watch out for the flashes of something coming out of hyperspeed.
Sure. Would Aldous or Owen like to do the same?
Yeah, I'll roll a perception with blue die because of my uncanny senses.
Yep.
I will not give you those advantage because I feel like we'd be doing this at the same time.
Another blue die?
He's not giving it to you.
Oh, no. Not? Okay, whatever. Anyway.
With your successes, as you're getting further in, and Morwenna is, like, you all can see the Lucre Hulk now. You can see the Lucre Hulk in view. It is on its side, and as you're getting closer, as you see your home city, Morwenna, Aldous, yep.
So, like, as, like, she sees her home city, she, like, looks over, and, like, this, like, rush of, like, nostalgia and sadness kind of comes over her, and she kind of like starts to tear up a little bit, and then like kind of like wipes it away and like steals herself, you know.
Can I use influence, or can I attempt to use influence on Morwenna?
In what way? Ooh.
I feel like as a seasoned knight, I can like feel the energies of people around me, and I would like to use my, I would feel Morwenna's emotions. I would like to use influence to kind of just set that at ease.
You certainly may.
And I hope you don't like mess that up.
As long as we roll a light size.
Oh yeah. No, God. She can't see through all the tears.
Well, you don't have to use it.
Yeah.
I'm going to anyway.
Okay. You gonna make it sadness?
Oh shit, I forgot I have to make it something sad. Never mind. Yeah, I won't use
it. Okay. You don't do it, you know, you wipe away your tears, Morwenna. But it is at this point, as you're getting closer and closer to the Lucre Hulk, Aldis and Owen, you see something leaving hyperspace, the vroom of a large destroyer. The first of what you know to be three.
The party is right.
Well, I'll definitely point it out to the group. But I don't know if there's any way I could know if they have seen us or not. Or have, like, picked up our like, signal.
I think they're just ordered to come here.
What was that?
So I think they were just ordered to come here, and we were already on planet anyway.
Oh, yeah, I don't think they're chasing us. I just didn't know if, like, you know, they come out of orbit and, you know, just see this Imperial cruiser or an Inquisitor shuttle just, you know, waltzing into orbit.
Probably wouldn't see us anyway, because we're already on planet.
Oh, okay.
I mean, okay.
I will make everyone know. I will make it known to everyone.
Yeah, our company's arrived.
Knowing that the company is arriving, could I make a space roll to try and, like, expedient our landing so that it's even more unlikely that they realize that we're there?
You certainly may.
Okay. I get to remove two black dice, steel jockey.
And Gonk helps.
Nice.
It doesn't matter.
You don't get a success, but you don't get a failure. So they're not gonna see you because of, you know, they're in space. However, it does, you know, take your time to find a good landing spot near the Lucre Hulk.
Right.
You know, within Yeah, you're not able to
a little slow.
Yeah, you take it a little slow. You're not able to go as fast as you want due to the canopy and the jungle environment, but you are able to land.
Actually, I will use my where the hell is that? Because I actually want to quote what it is so that talents. I think it's talents. Where is that? Anyways, I'm pretty sure I have a talent that lets me re-roll a single planetary or space check once a game.
I believe you do.
Yeah, that's
cool. So, I will use that for kicks and giggles and roll again.
Okay.
So, is that blue?
There we go.
You are going to take a strain, but you are able to expedite it, and you go in hot and are able to speed up your landing next to the Lucre Hulk. You know, maybe everyone has to hold on a little bit, but you are able to land faster.
As he kind of, like, levels out and we approach the Lucre Hulk, I would ask Master Windu if there is an eldest of the younglings. Because I'm assuming.
And then the one next
actually, I will ask Windu if he intends to come with us to find Morwina's family, or if he's going to stay with the younglings.
He's going to say that he. I would like to take the crystal you found on Mimban and stay with the younglings and add it to their sabers.
I will give him a communicator so that he can stay in contact with us.
You will take it.
And I no longer care about the younglings. Or to talk to them.
Are you going to give Mace the crystal?
Yes.
Okay. Yep. And you guys are able to land. You see the massive sideways Lucre Hulk in front of you. Outside of the windows. What's the plan, gang? You're on Mikkia. There is at least one destroyer in space with two more on the way. And there's a Lucre Hulk in front of you.
Mando, can you scan that to see what maybe the safest part of it to enter would be?
You got it.
Okay. You can give me... We'll just call it another computers. I'm gonna put the difficulty. And Gonk is gonna help you.
Ready when you are.
It is set.
Roger, roger.
You are able to scan it. You're able to
roger,
scan
roger.
The Hulk. There we go. You're able to scan the Lucre Hulk. And you're able to see a similar, or Morwenna, you would be able to spot this too, just off the rip, but there seems to be a large hole in the side of the Lucre Hulk that is actually stable on the ground that seems to have been blasted open when it likely crashed or possibly from a space battle that is large enough for you to walk through.
Point that out.
And Mando, you're able to scan that as well. And you're not, yeah, with your would... scan, you do not scan any fellow droids within yet.
Actually, matter of fact, I think she would try to, like, land close to that hole.
Yeah, and you would be able to. And okay. Mando, what were you saying?
Oh, I was going to say, not to be a backseat pilot, but I was thinking if the cargo bay was still open, you could, like, kind of fly into it and maybe land on a wall or something.
You mean the cargo of the Lucre Hulk, if we could pilot
into
that.
Yeah, like if one of the Lucre Hulk
landing bases
was open, we could just slide right in.
If Morwenna wants to spend a destiny point to say one of the landing bays are open and blasted open of the Lucre Hulk.
Is everyone alright with that?
Yeah,
no, we have three light side. Yeah, I'll use a light side to, like,
and they definitely
say that there's,
it,
like...
sitting outside.
Yeah. You're able to... There's an open blast door that you're able to actually fly in. It's a bit higher up in the Lucre Hulk, but you are able to fly in and land. It's not the most stable of ground, considering how the Lucre Hulk is currently placed. But you are able to land.
At least this way the ship's hidden as well.
I'll look at Owen and Master Windu, and I'll ask if we should venture in a little bit to ensure that, to find a good spot to, for all the younglings to hide up.
We must also
make
sure that...
I think that's the wise idea.
No old threats are around.
Exactly.
I just give Mace that look. Like,
Mace definitely gives you a look, but seeing as how you're a quote-unquote domesticated commando droid.
Mace is looking at you.
If Mando could eye roll, he would.
Beat you with my bare hands.
Yeah.
My bare hand.
Oh, man. Mando is essentially the robot version of that, like, dog and cat meme.
Yeah.
And listen, from what Aldous just said, Mace Windu could beat up people with his one hand. I mean, have you seen the animated? He destroyed a whole battalion with just his hands.
One second, I'm working on it.
Okay, so we're venturing into... I don't think... Is everyone going in, or is someone staying here, or... Someone's probably got to stay with the pad ones, because I don't think they're going to make sure there's no threats with us, so...
I think this... Seeing as how the Imperials are just now entering, like... Or just exiting hyperspace, I feel like we could all leave the ship without the younglings if we wanted. Or, like, they could follow, like, behind. Because it's not like this is a wild planet.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So if they just, like, hung behind us, I'm sure they'd at least be able to get away if something were to kill all of us.
Hmm.
Or they could just stay on the ship. I just wouldn't ask any of the party to stay on the ship.
Wow.
And skip a potential combat.
I know, personally, Morwenna is definitely interested in, like, leaving the ship and, like, exploring old, you know, hideaway.
Master, are you okay with the Padawan staying to stay safe?
He would approach the Padawans and inform them they are going to search the surrounding areas to make sure it is safe, and should anything happen, that
Gonk can fly them out of here, probably.
To believe in the Force and trust the Gonk.
Yeah, Merwinna will look at Gonk and be like, Gonk, if anything happens, you know, radio communicate us.
Mm-hmm. And
I will also show where the communicators are if any of the younglings have to get in contact with us.
They could point out the main communicator on the ship in the cockpit.
And one of the...
Which is linked to our comms.
One of the younglings, I will actually put them on the map.
Oh no, if they're on the map, that means they can die.
No, I'm just giving them to you so you can see the most intrigued one. The one, when you're telling them about the communicators, the one who seems to possibly be the eldest, or the one who seems to be the most interested and, you know, paying attention. I forget the name of their species, but it is this little fella. Ithorian. It is an Ithorian youngling who seems to be paying the most attention and is the one who's, like, taking in this, you know, life or death situation. They're listening. They understand.
He has one of those
much like the one that got gadded by Grievous in the 2003 movie.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think any of us asked beforehand. How old are the younglings? Like, what's the age range?
The youngest, looks to be at least, you know, like, you know, young for
or since
their...
like species are different, how is there, like, one that's closer to being taken for a Padawan than others, or are they all, like, pretty, they're still, like, young.
The Ithorian, they all definitely seem to be, you know, youngling age.
Okay.
The Ithorian seems to be the oldest, with the youngest being the human, who seems to be, like, at most, like, you know, 6 years old.
That's tough.
So, there's only, like, a couple of them that are probably ready to be taken as Padawans in the traditional sense.
There's at least, like, two that would really be ready for a Padawan.
The Ithorian and one of the others?
The Ithorian and a Rodian.
Ooh.
Yeah, you got the Rodian, fam.
Let's go.
And I'll pop the Rodian on the map as well.
All right,
my future Padawan, let's go.
I was about to say you better be thinking of some names and backstories for future reference.
Here is the
Rodian. I've been doing that anyway.
But those the Ithorian and the Rodian seem to be the two closest to possible Padawan age.
Cool.
But assuming you set down the ramp and head into Lucre Hulk.
Interesting. Nice.
Is that the plan?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Leaving Gonk in charge.
You all set off into Lucre Hulk. You're able to have lights. You know, you can set up, like, you know, Star Wars flashlights to be able to see in the Lucre Hulk. Because it is dark. There are maybe, like, wires spinning about still.
I'm assuming Mace and Aldous and I would have our sabers out.
Yeah, activated. Mine's not activated because I don't want to set anything off, but mine is my hand at the ready.
I'm pretty sure Mando's eyes kind of act like a flashlight.
Yeah, or even like dark, like night vision.
You can see in the dark, yeah.
Yeah, because don't commandos have like infrared?
Yes, they do.
So you are all walking through the quiet corridors of the Lucre Hulk, and I'm going to ask, you all can decide, I'm going to ask for two perceptions, two characters to give me a perception. Which two would you like that to be?
Okay. I definitely have a high.
Yeah, I was going to say.
I'll take it if no one else wants to.
Aldous has better die than me, yeah.
So Aldous.
And then, right, so myself and Mando, sounds like
Armando.
All right.
I don't know. Did Mace give himself a cool robo eye?
No.
Oh.
It's just a blind eye.
So, perception from Aldous. Do you have anything to add to it?
Did anyone use those advantages from Morwina? Morwina's piloting? Or can I use those?
I believe this would be considered a new scene.
Okay. Well, unless I'm sensing from dark side users, then no, I have nothing to add to it.
Okay. The role is set. Same from Mando. Do you have anything you can add to a perception? Any talents or anything?
Let me check.
I think I do have dark vision, if that changes anything.
I think it's combat, yeah. I mean, you already have a success.
Yeah, I just didn't know for like future reference.
That is a good point I think. Yeah, you definitely do need to tell me, because I think your dark vision would have negated that black die. It would have gotten rid of the black die.
Okay,
so.
Yeah, I do remove two setback die from checks due to darkness.
There you go.
Okay.
Well, all this, you're still able to hear, you know, you're all walking through, you can hear the creaking of this old Lucre Hulk. The hallways where perhaps some of you may have fought before, depending on how active you were in the Clone Wars. I don't think all this was.
Not for long. I would have been active for a little bit and then was knighted and started doing spooky... shadow stuff.
So perhaps you are familiar with the hallways. At least recognize some of them. But you're walking through with your perception, all this. You're able to see the... Well, not corpses, because they're not corpses, but the remnants of destroyed B1s and B2s strewn about. You see a couple B2s with what seem to be holes through their chests, but they aren't holes similar to that of a blaster. It is very much lightsaber damage.
Maybe before they crashed.
I'll kind of like slow the party and walk ahead, and I'll point out to Windu. And I'll ask him, do you know what Jedi would have been assigned to this section during the Clone Wars? Or to this planet during the Clone Wars?
I am going to pick the best Jedi. Because we don't know much about him.
Quinlan Vos. Quinlan Vos.
He would say... Quinlan
Vos.
No, even better. Even better.
I know.
Lies and slander. I don't care who it is.
Lies and slander. One moment, please, because I need to find the information. Well, this is an issue. Did I ever get a name? Did you ever have a name, Morwenna?
I'm quite sure it's somewhere in our DMs.
I will say this. Yeah, man does need a name. I will work to find it, but what Mace Windu would say would be the name of your father, Morwenna.
Yeah, she would tear up a little bit at that mention.
A name I do not know.
Let's see, all I have in the backstory is that they were Jedi. I'm not seeing a name.
Hold on just a sec, I'm going to jump to that location. Because I'm quite sure I did put a name.
I know I have names for your mother and your siblings.
Right. Oh man, I could have swore I fucking wrote a name.
Well, you can come up with one right now if there isn't one.
Okay. Let me think for a second.
Yep, but the name would be recognizable to you, Morwenna, as your father. And if the Jedi want to, they can give me a role that the two of you would deem appropriate for trying to remember this. I'm going to let you pick the role and convince me of it.
Hmm.
Originally, I was going to say warfare. I'm not sure if that would fit well, so I'm going to let you pick the role.
A role to recognize the name?
To recognize the name, yes.
I would... I think...
Education?
I think education would be fair for me. I feel like yours should be like some kind of memory. Because if it's a like a master, you'd be more likely to know them on a better level than me, just like hearing just, the name.
I don't know what to roll.
And you know, that's actually a question. Morwenna, were they a knight or were they a master?
I think they might have been a knight. I don't want to, like, you know, overhype my, like, backstory and, you know, family and all that. So, yeah, probably just a knight.
And we have a name now, which I will type Jedi Master, Jedi Knight, Zucron.
Oh.
So you can do an education, Aldous.
Yeah, I'll do an education. All right.
Mm.
Name doesn't ring a bell.
I don't think I have anything better, so...
The name does not ring a bell to you all, but Mace... To Mace, it does. And Mace will tell you that during the Clone Wars, Jedi Knight Zucron was a stalwart defender of this system of Mikkia, being a Mikkian themselves. He took it upon himself to defend the planet from the... droid attacks on the Wookiees, and he took it upon himself to defend the planet when war came to its steps. So this is likely his old handiwork.
Did he live long enough to see Order 66?
Ooh.
Yes.
Yes.
Out of game real quick, he survived Order 66.
I was about to ask the question, did he survive?
And yeah, I mean, Mace Windu would tell the story how he heard it, unless Morwenna pipes up and says anything.
She wouldn't say anything unless it was, like, incomplete information. Yeah.
But otherwise, Mace Windu tells the story as question he...
Yeah.
Mace Windu tells the story as he knew the story of Jedi Knight Zucron.
Who was his master? That's a question.
Morwenna does not know that. She was still pretty young when he died.
I don't know if that matters, because knights could serve on their own.
Perhaps that was the case, because Mace would not be able to answer that question.
Let's hope he still continues to survive. Perhaps soon we can try to find him as well.
Does you say that out loud?
I do say that out loud as I continue to like lead us forward, since I realize I have dark vision and can probably see better than everyone except Mando.
Morwenna would say that's not gonna happen. He's dead.
I'll stop and kind of like slowly turn and you sound sure.
You can see that there's like a tear in her eye, and she's like, I'm very sure. I watched it happen.
Damn. I don't think Owen. Ooh. I'm just curious as to what I would roll if
I'm not. I'm here. Not good with words, so I will
dice,
nod no. solemnly and turn and continue to walk.
Yeah,
at least he took some of these down before Liquor Hulk crashes.
And kind of with a solemn tone, Mace also continues walking forward. with the lightsaber shining. As you begin moving on, sticking with the old perception from Aldous with you in the front, as everyone's walking, Morwenna, are you following in pace? Do you stop for a moment to, you know, survey the damaged droids that your father took down? Or do you walk in pace with the group?
He's looking, like, I mean, she's a little bit slower now. Because, like, one, now she's kind of realizing, right? Because she didn't, like, when she used to play here as a kid, she didn't know that this was her dad's handiwork, right? So, like, she's kind of looking at it with, like, a new level of, like, awe and reverence, you know?
Mm-hmm. So Merwenna, you know, is taking time, but the rest continue walking on a bit ahead. You can see throughout the more hallways, Aldous, more damaged droids, unmoving, and you see some, you know, some sliding doors that are struggling, like, you know, like in like apocalypse movies, the elevators that are closing and opening constantly.
Ah, yes.
Some don't doors
open inside.
Yeah, some doors are kind of like that. More stringing wires. You can see burn marks across some of the walls and the floor. The handiwork of a lightsaber. They seem old. And as you're walking,
I'm gonna have Dio scan the area now.
Okay.
Alrighty, and I will scan.
Tell Dio, can you scan for incoming threats?
Okay, and 1 second.
I will nod and kind of walk ever so behind Aldous and start my scan.
Sure, give me a computers. You are scanning. You're not really able to tell anything. You're not able to see anything through your scan. At least in your current area, however. Aldous and Mando, thanks to your scanning, you're able to hear that first. You know, there's a very distinct sound of metal on metal as Mando's walking. But somewhere off in the distance, maybe a further room, the two of you hear the sound of more metal on metal. And it doesn't sound like the sounds of, like, crates or items being, you know, dragged out of the ship just due to the positioning. It sounds like something is moving.
Like droids walking.
Perhaps further down the hallway and behind what looks to be a closed door.
I will alert the rest of the group and is the door like open or is it completely closed? You said, or is that one of the doors that's like doing the open and shut?
You've passed doors that have been doing open and shut. As you look into it, they look a bit too steep to be able to walk into. So like sticking to your hallway, the sound of, you know, more metal on metal you're hearing is from the end of your hallway behind what looks to be a closed door.
Could I try to sneak? Could I stop the group and try to sneak up on the door and, like, partially open it so I could look inside?
Certainly. Is there a... There's a stealth, right?
There is a stealth, and I've not gotten to use it yet.
You may roll me a stealth. And then roll me a perception. As you kind of open the door a little bit. Alright, I'm going to use that threat to my own advantage. You are able to open the door a little bit. You're really having to strain to it because the door is fighting back to shut on you.
It's a very old ship.
Yeah. But as you open it, you're not at the bridge. You know, you're still in just one of the random sections of the side of the ship. So this is just another, like, random room within the ship, within the Lucre Hulk.
Okay.
But you are able to see remnants, but moving remnants of a small group of slow-moving, but still moving B1s. There's at least four or five B1s, and they seem to be, you know when Grievous is on, I think, Toydaria, and he's with the troop, and they're, like, losing their battery? The droids.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're kind of, like, bugging out.
They seem to be at that stage where they're losing their battery. They're very slow.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay. But there seems to be four or five B1s, and there seems to be at least what you can see, at least one B2 with the rocket arm.
Okay. I'm assuming I've snuck far enough away that I can't whisper, so I'll whisper in my comm. Squadron of droids behind this door, a handful of B1s, and at least one B2.
And I'll look over to Mando and ask if
you are Mando.
Like I should make contact. Oh, I am Mando. Okay, Owen. My apologies.
Mando, you're
you look in the mirror.
Of course. And ask if I can make contact.
That could be interesting.
I'll lean back in. They don't look like they're all there. They're moving very jankily and
like they're twitchy. Running out of power.
And they do seem to actually
deal with
real quick all this. You can actually hear they do seem to be talking to each other. Very slowly, some of the B1s, you know, are talking to each other, like, every few words you hear, you know, where is Commander? We need batteries. One of them very slowly slaps the side of another one's head and says, Moron, you are the Commander.
Roger, roger.
Mm-hmm. But they are having conversation with each other about their battery. And the commander responds, the commander responds to the one that slowly slapped it, and he says, if I had enough power, I would send you to the brig.
Pretty sad, not gonna lie. I'll whisper in again. These guys don't have much power left. It may be easier if we just dispatch them and be certain that they're done.
Hearing that, yeah, I would just move up behind you and get ready.
And as you all move up to get ready to breach the room, that is where we're gonna end the session.
Will put my fist through this desk.
That is where we will end the session, and I'm going to give you all, let us say, 15 experience points.
Sheesh!
15.
You will get 15 experience points, and we
shall...
I think
I can buy something now.
Whoa! And we shall hopefully see you, dear viewers, next time. As the party advance through a Lucre Hulk and deal with some slowly dying battle droids. For now, though, may the Force be with you, and everyone say goodbye to YouTube.
Bye, YouTube.
Bye, goodbye. YouTube.
Goodbye, YouTube.
YouTube.
See you next time.